Who was that poor woman? I saw her last moments and felt what she did. The end was sudden. She did not see the killer. Her scream was silenced by a male's left hand covered in a leather glove. The killer said nothing, but his mouth was open. His breath came slightly down on her. Judging by her height, the killer could not have been tall. I'm going to explore the neighborhood and learn this woman's name. It fits, and a bootmaker would have interest in the victim's missing footwear. Knock, knock! If I find solid proof that John Pizer is the killer, he won't get far. This is the victim's missing boot. It proves Pizer was at the crime scene and did not inform the police. But was he the killer? I found plenty of shoes, but no traces of blood. I sensed she smelled the leather of the glove that covered her mouth, but not a heavier scent like the hide used in soles or boot polish. Mr. Pizer may have been trying to steal a pair of shoes to sell in his shop, but had to flee before he could finish for fear of being linked to the murder. I can learn more about the victim if I track where she began her walk. Which tracks do I follow? Thank you. Pizer definitely made a path to the victim. He saw her, but did he kill her? There's no doubt about it. The victim connects with this building. She might live here. The killer is playing cat and mouse with a person of authority in this time period. Is the murderer of Andrew Chapman a present-day copycat? I hear deliberate noises. I am not alone. Someone else was here. That isn't her bite mark. Since when does a woman have mustache hairs? Her ring was not on her body, and it isn't here. Just like Andrew Chapman. Wonder what ailed her, and where she got this brand of Hocus Pocus snake oil. A patient wolf. Good with sharp tools left this here, or gave it as a gift. Her name was Annie Chapman.